Well, I think it was a robust discussion, a very spirited and I think thoughtful discussion. I was really proud of all of our Democratic members of the Illinois House of Representatives. There were lots and lots of questions and answers, and we went through everything in the budget. And you know, I think a lot of folks have more information today than they started with before the meeting. And part of our process of democracy is to work together through this month to make sure that we get a budget that's a decent budget that preserves and protects education and other important priorities like health care and human service and public safety. I was very proud of all the Democrats, how committed they are to that function and that mission, and I know we're going to get there.
So you're saying
you didn't get borrowing, you didn't get a tax increase. Where are those profiles in courage you were talking about a few months ago?
Well, I think that when we finally get a vote on the budget, we'll have a lot of profiles in courage. I think there are a lot of people in the meeting today that indicated that they're willing to make some tough sacrifices on behalf of the people of Illinois. The members are willing to take furlough days for themselves in order to tighten their belts, and we're doing the same thing. All the people in the executive branch, including me, are taking furlough days, and many other economies. So we have to do that for sure. We have to cut costs. At the same time, we have to make sure we have important things that matter to everyday people who are counting on us protected. We're going to have full funding from for education, the same kind of funding we had last year.
How are you going to get that? Where are you going to get that, Governor?
Well, I think that, you know, we have a very, very good team of people that work on our budget, and we've answered many, many questions that came up today. The legislators are thoughtful people. They should be. They're elected by their districts to look at everything. I think they're going to take a little bit of time here to reflect upon the answers today and work today and tomorrow and whatever other days we need in order to get a fair budget for everyday people.
So no adjournment tonight. No adjournment today.
Well, we'll see. I think it's important for the members to feel comfortable with what they're voting on. And I understand democracy. Democracy is not something that you just push a button and everything happens. It has to be a give and take of dialogue and discussion. I'm always happy to participate in these accountability sessions. I think the governors before me didn't do this. I come to the caucus. They ask plenty of questions. I gave answers, my staff did the same, and I think we're farther along in getting the process to where we want it to be for the people.
Is the Senate budget, the Senate budget's the one that's coming together? Senate passed.
Well, I know they passed it last night. I commend President John Cullerton. He's a good leader. He was able to get the votes for a budget plan, and now obviously there's the second house, and that's the one we're working
Does
on right now.
Does this budget include full funding for education?
Yeah, I think there's no question that everybody in the room was united on making sure that we have full funding for education, that we are able to protect that, and that's always been my goal from day
one. Does it include a cigarette tax increase?
That's part of our overall plan, and you know, that was discussed. There will be, you know, a lot of other elements that fit in as well.
What about slots of tracks?
Yeah, I think there'll probably be a vote today on that. I was very disappointed in Senator Brady running around trying to prevent a bipartisan agreement on borrowing money to make sure we meet our pension obligations. That's the best way to go, the fiscally sound way to go. We did it last year with bipartisan support. You know, we don't want anybody in Illinois government, including Senator Brady, to just think you can foment chaos. We're not going to let that happen. Now, I'm the governor of Illinois, and we're going to do things right. We're not going to let politicians just try and make everything political. That's not what the people want. They want the elected representatives to work together to solve a problem. And we're in a tough, tough budget situation in our state, like other states, and we have to work together as a team to get to the right place where the people are happy with the budget.
Are you assuming that the Senate president accepts the slots at tracks?
Oh, I don't think that's really part of the deal. I don't think that wasn't discussed at all.
Would you even find that if that came to you?
I don't really like to give opinions on hypotheticals. I don't believe that's going forward.
You've not been a fan of that, right?
No, I'm not. Well, I mean, that particular issue really didn't come up this morning. I don't really think it's going to be moving anywhere.
Do you wish you would have started this dialogue sooner with House Democrats before today?
No, I've had a lot of dialogue with House Democrats. I talk to members all the time. Well, that's what I do. I talk individually with members, and I will continue to do that. I think it is good from time to time to have a gathering of our entire caucus and to talk from the heart about how important it is that we, the people, work together for the public interest and the common good. And that's really what this was. I believe in accountability and having the opportunity to answer questions and explain things is good. It's healthy for our democracy. It was a very thoughtful discussion. I was so impressed by how many members had thoughtful questions about matters affecting their district, matters affecting our state. I think the people of Illinois should be proud of our elected members of the General Assembly.
Well, what does it say about the state of this legislative body that they've rushed a 2,300-page budget in 2 days?
Well, yeah, I think you mean in the Senate? Are you referring
to? Trying to rush this entire budget in the last 2 days before leaving town.
There's been a whole lot of discussion on this.
But they haven't had any legislation until just recently, and they haven't seen any legislation until now.
There's a lot of discussion. That's what today was. This is an opportunity for everybody to come together, have questions asked and answers given, and I think it was what the people of Illinois want. They want their elected representatives to do their job as legislators. I got to do my job as the governor. I present ideas and then answer questions. You know, overall, this has been a very good legislative session for some fundamental reforms. Nursing home reform, telecommunications reform. I was very happy that the property tax relief measures got through both houses yesterday. We were going to work a little bit on the sales tax holiday. So these are things that are good things for the people back home. And I said to the legislators today how impressed I was and how they did their work, and that'll continue.